my beauties, welcome back. Today we're gonna be doing a video that I have been waiting to do for so long. I am so excited. We are going to be talking about dry shampoos, drugstore, and high-end, and I have literally two huge boxes of empty dry shampoo bottles. Well, except one. I think this one has still a little bit in there just because it's a newer one. These are the dry shampoos I have been literally collecting for the past couple of months, trying to test them out for you guys, kind of going through them one by one and making mental notes on them. And I'm finally sitting down and being able to record this video and review for you guys. I am a complete dry shampoo fanatic. If you have been with my channel for any amount of time, you will know that I cannot live without dry shampoo. Dry shampoo is definitely a necessity for me. I feel like, you know, second day hair need just a tiny bit of, you know, volume in it. I do believe that a good dry shampoo can make the biggest difference in your hairstyle. I always have like people ask me, because sometimes like if I do style and like actually do something with my hair, they ask me like what I do with it, and most of the time it's pretty much just kind of like dry shampoo, because if you have a good dry shampoo that has a little bit of texture, that gives you a little bit of volume, that definitely like absorbs all the oils, it can make the biggest difference in the way your hair looks. And so that's kind of my secret most of the time, especially if I'm going out or if I'm doing anything and I haven't washed my hair that same day. You know, I feel like it's a great thing to kind of just freshen up. And even sometimes, like, I have a couple dry shampoos that are extreme, like, texturizers. I would use a dry shampoo even that same day instead of hairspray to kind of just give my hair a little bit more bounce and a little bit more volume. And I do try to avoid hairsprays unless I'm doing, like, a super tight curl or something, because I don't like that, like, stickiness. And I haven't found my perfect hairspray yet, so I'm definitely working on that, too. But for dry shampoos, like I said, I have so many bottles. There's probably over 30 bottles. I have a ton of repeats from the ones that I do absolutely adore. Oh my gosh, these are so dusty. Oh my gosh, this is embarrassing. But they've been sitting here for quite some time, so that's why they might be just a little bit dusty. But you know, that kind of tells you the amount of time I've been trying to do this video for you guys for. And so just like I do most of my reviews for makeup or beauty in general, I kind of have split up all the dry shampoos into three categories. Ones that are my favorites that I absolutely love, that have all the qualities that I am looking for, here in this case, dry shampoo. Then the second category are going to be ones that are pretty good, aren't my favorite, so they haven't met like my complete expectations, but that aren't bad either, and that I could like potentially rebuy them or reuse them, but they're just not my complete favorites, ride or die dry shampoos. And then the third category are going to be dry shampoos that I did not enjoy for one reason or another. I will share those reasons with you guys as well, and I would not repurchase. I most likely would not recommend those. I will try to have some extra information on the screen for you guys. I will also list all these dry shampoos in the comments down below, just in case you guys are wondering what the names are or what they are. Now, if you guys are wondering how I graded these dry shampoos and how I decided which category they're gonna go into, I kind of based my judgment and opinion on five basic things that I am looking for in a dry shampoo. So I kind of graded them based on whether or not they are oil absorbing, whether or not they're like texturizing or volumizing, based on their scent, based on their like white cast or like residue that they have, and then also overall performance to see if they have improved my hairstyle in general. I do apologize if you guys hear any noise in the background. I think one of my neighbors is cutting grass, and so it's unfortunate timing, but we're just gonna have to kind of deal through it. Now, last thing I will mention and do is throw out a disclaimer out there. If any of the dry shampoos that I might not like, you guys enjoy or work for you in particular, please do not get offended, because I feel like everyone has different expectations of different makeup and beauty products in general. So I do think it's all based on personal preference, and I will try to be as descriptive as I can for you guys while reviewing these, just so you guys can be your own judge and kind of decide whether or not you think think these would work and which ones would and wouldn't work for you guys. But that'd be it for the intro. I hope you guys enjoy this video and let's jump into it. So I decided instead of making you guys wait till the end of the video for me to like let you guys know which dry shampoos are my favorite, I decided that my favorites are gonna be the first dry shampoos I talk about. And I do have a favorite that is high-end, and I do have a favorite that is drugstore. And if you have been following me for quite some time, you guys probably already know what my favorites are. And even though I do test out so many dry shampoos, these are my favorite ones. And you can kind of tell by the fact that there are literally like multiples of the same kind. So my ultimate ride or die favorite dry shampoo that's a little bit more on the high end scale is the Wella dry shampoo. This is a German brand of dry shampoo and I just love everything about it. I feel like it has the perfect balance of absorbing all the oils and refreshing your hair, but at the same time giving you a little bit of texture, but not too much texture to the point where like your hair get like sticky or untamable. And so I love this dry shampoo. This has been one of my favorites for quite some time, and I haven't been able to find anything that kind of beats this for me. And I get mine at Ulta. It has a pretty nice scent. It doesn't leave too big of a white cast, which now that my hair is lighter, I don't really mind as much if a dry shampoo leaves like a whiter cast in my hair, because I can just, you know, kind of shake it out and it will go away. But overall, this is like my number one dry shampoo. And I literally, okay, let me show you guys. And these are all like empty. Like there's no product in it because I've used them up, because these are my favorite ones. I have 5 bottles of this, and I usually try to wait if Ulta has a sale to get these. Now, my favorite dry shampoo from the drugstore that comes really, really close to the Wella dry shampoo, if not almost on the same kind of level, is this Pantene Pro-V dry shampoo. I feel like, once again, these two are my favorite, so I feel like it has a perfect balance of all the 5 kind of qualifications that I am looking for in a dry shampoo. I feel like it's definitely oil absorbing. I feel like the texture, it definitely gives a little bit of texture, which I personally do enjoy in my dry shampoo. That's why some of these other dry shampoos haven't worked out for me, because they give me like no volume, no texture whatsoever. I do like a little bit of texture, if you guys are wondering, and I feel like these are a perfect balance of that. They smell pretty great. They don't leave like that much of any kind of white cast, and overall performance, like this and the Wella dry shampoo are by far my favorite. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and jump back and forth between high-end and drugstore. So my second favorite high-end dry shampoo would have to be the Arn Co. Death Valley dry shampoo. Now, I have not gotten a big size of this just because I've been testing so many other dry shampoos. But the second I'm done with some of the dry shampoos that I'm using right now, I will go ahead and repurchase a couple of the big bottles. This is a little bit on the pricier side, of course, but I love the way this smells. Like, the scent in this is like rated number one in probably any of these other dry shampoos. And it's really hard for me to describe how this smells, but it's like a super fresh, like outdoors, but sweet scent. It kind of reminds me of like the desert, but in the most beautiful way you can possibly imagine. And I just love the way this smells. And also, I do like the way this performs. I feel like it definitely gives a little bit of volume and not too much of a texturizer, in my opinion. But I do feel like it definitely absorbs all the oils and it refreshes your hair. And the scent, just the scent of this dry shampoo, like I just can't get over. Okay, moving on back to drugstore, my second favorite drugstore overall shampoo would have to be the Batiste dry shampoo, but not any other scent, but this sweetie scent. I absolutely like fell in love with it not too long ago. Now, it definitely did not grade as high as the Pantene Pro-V one, but the one in the sweetie scent, which has these cute little tiny dolls, and I've tried different ones because I've tried like different scents from Batiste, and I don't really like many of them besides this one. I feel like the scent is really nice and kind of pushes me over the edge to have this as one of my favorites. Now let me go over the details about this dry shampoo. This dry shampoo definitely will give you a bit of a white cast. Now I don't really mind it, like I said earlier, just because my hair is lighter, so I can kind of just shake it in and it's not like permanent staying. But if you do have darker hair, I don't know if I would recommend this dry shampoo to you guys, because you might have that issue of it leaving like a white cast, literally like white powder in your hair. But it is really, really, really good in oil absorption. I feel like even after like a couple of days, I can put this dry shampoo in my hair and it will like eliminate any type of oiliness or any type of, you know, greasiness that I might have in my hair. So it's definitely very effective. I also would comment on this dry shampoo that it's not super texturizing. I feel like it's almost like minimal texturizer, but because I feel like it is very powerful in like the oil absorption, I don't really mind it, and I do kind of overlook the fact that it lacks in like super texturizing. But this would be my like second pick from the drugstore. My third pick from the drugstore I actually don't have, because it'd be the Tresemme one, the one with the black and the yellow cap. I feel like that one's really good from the drugstore as well, and I feel like it's a little bit more texturizing than this one, but it's not as good as the Pantene Pro V one in my opinion. But it definitely grades as a really nicely balanced dry shampoo in my opinion. Now moving on to my third favorite high-end dry shampoo, and I am talking about high-end dry shampoo, is this Orbea dry shampoo. Now I have tried a couple different sample sizes and I absolutely love it. I have been kind of battling with myself whether or not I want to spend the money and buy an actual big bottle. Now if I was to take away the price aspect of this dry shampoo, I would buy it and repurchase it in a heartbeat, because I feel like this is another one of those dry shampoos that's very balanced and well balanced. So it doesn't give you like a white cast. It smells amazing. And actually Orbea has one of my favorite like hair conditioning treatments. And so these are scented the same type of way. It has their like signature scent, which I am a huge fan of. And I did really enjoy the way like this felt in my hair. And like I said, if I didn't have the drugstore options of having a really good dry shampoo, this would be definitely one of my to-go dry shampoos for sure. No doubts about it. Okay, so we pretty much finished with the box of my favorites. I gave you guys three high-end that I absolutely do enjoy and do recommend, and three from the drugstore that I feel like are really up there, you know, that can compare to some of the high-end dry shampoos I talked about. All right, so now we're gonna move into the mixed box, which has some dry shampoos that were okay, but not the best, not the worst. And it has some dry shampoos in here that I would not recommend and would not repurchase. And so let's just go ahead and jump into it. Ones that I did enjoy that I feel like were pretty good, weren't the best that I've ever used, but were pretty decent that I might repurchase in the future if I was to like see them. First is the Pearlescent Dry Shampoo. This is in the Cherry Blossom scent. I actually am trying one right now that is a jasmine something scent, and I did really enjoy this one. This one is definitely better than the one I'm using right now in the Cherry Blossom scent, but that's just because I really like cherry blossoms. I do feel like it gives a little bit of texture. I don't think it's as powerful in like taking care of the greasy mess. I feel like I do need a little bit more of this compared to some of the other ones I talked about. But overall, I do enjoy it. It's not one of my favorites, but it's not the worst either. I do think it gets the job done, and I do like the way this one smells. Another dry shampoo that I actually was debating whether or not to put it in my favorites pile is the Amika dry shampoo. Now this one I feel like has very low of a white powder cast. I do think it really does kind of amp up your hair quite a bit. Now I wouldn't say that this has a perfect texturizing quality to it, but it definitely just revives and refreshes your hair, and it smells really nice as well. Yeah, I really do enjoy the scent. Now, to be honest with you guys, this one was a definite runner-up to my second place in my favorites dry shampoo. So this one definitely gets two thumbs up from me. I would recommend it. I feel like it's on the border of being my favorite, one of my favorite dry shampoos. So I did really enjoy it, and I would advise you guys to check it out if you guys are interested. Now, before we move on, I did want to mention that the Living Proof dry shampoo is definitely a great dry shampoo as well. I do feel like it's one of those ones that are pretty balanced in my like qualifications for a dry shampoo. So the next few dry shampoo bottles I have, I'm gonna kind of just go through them really quickly because they weren't some of my favorites and I probably would not repurchase them if I had an option to purchase something else. And so one of them includes the Detox Dry Shampoo. This was a sample that I received that I didn't really enjoy. It's from Drybar. I'm not really even exactly sure like what just wasn't working for me, but it wasn't one of my favorites. This next one from Organics, this wasn't too bad. I actually have two of these, which I like the Coconut Miracle scented one a little bit better than the Moroccan Oil one. Once again, these were nice. They weren't anything like extravagant. They weren't anything that were like super awful either. And if I were to repurchase them, I most likely wouldn't, just because I do have my other preferences that I do enjoy more. And same thing goes for this IGK one. This is the Jet Lag Invisible Dry Shampoo. And I will say that this one did have minimal like white cast. So if that's something you're interested in or are looking for, maybe this would be a good one for you to try out. But overall, I do think it got the job done, but would it be my favorite? I mean, not really. Now, these two other ones from the drugstore, the Batiste and the Blush scent, I do really like enjoy the Sweetie scent. The Blush scent is okay, but I do prefer the other one. And I feel like the formula for this is pretty great because it is a very powerful dry shampoo from the drugstore. But I think it's just a preference of the scent. Now, this one from L'Oreal, this is the Longwear Dry Shampoo. Same thing. It wasn't bad, it wasn't awful, but it wasn't one of my favorites. And this one also claims that it not only refreshes and absorbs oils, but it extends the style. And I don't know if that's necessarily true. I do usually look for like a texturizer or something that will extend my hairstyle, but I didn't really think that this did that much to my hair. So once again, it's just gonna go in the okay pile. Now, I'm not sure if I mentioned this Bumble and Bumble dry shampoo yet. I did really enjoy it for quite some time. I feel like the formula is definitely there. It does leave like a slight white cast, but my issue with this is the scent of it. I feel like over time, I've used it for the past like 2 weeks. I just actually finished it the other day. Now, I think the scent of this one is the factor that kind of made it not be in my favorites and not in the ones that I really, really do enjoy. Even though, like I said, I do like the formula. I think it gets the job done. It's just the scent kind of really gets tiring after a while, and it almost is like, and it's almost like I got really bored of the scent to the point where it's kind of really musky, and it almost like, I don't want to say like it started giving me a headache, but it kind of was like a distraction for me. Even though this is one of the dry shampoos that I really did enjoy, the scent of it kind of made me not like it as much over time. And so that's why it's in my just okay pile. Alright, so now we're down to the last box, which is the duds. These are dry shampoos that I will for sure not repurchase, that I did not enjoy for one reason or another, and I just didn't like what they did to my hair. I don't think they met my expectations of a dry shampoo, and so I just figured I'd share these with you guys just so you guys can kind of maybe avoid them or pick something else if you are shopping for a dry shampoo. So the first one I would not recommend is one from Herbal Essence, and the scent on this is absolutely amazing. It smells kind of like grapefruits and citrusy, like super refreshing scent. My issue with this dry shampoo is that it was almost too texturizing. Like it was almost like if you were to combine a hairspray and a dry shampoo in one, but not in a good way. It made my hair really like sticky. I don't want to say that it made my hair stiff, but it pretty much did. And I feel like instead of emphasizing my style, it kind of brought it down a little bit. And it also made my hair a bit tangly. And so even though it might have absorbed my oils okay, the scent was delicious as well. It just did not, like the texture of this was not one of my favorites. And so therefore I would not recommend this one. The next one I wouldn't really recommend or repurchase is the Mother, Not Your Mother's Clean Freak Dry Shampoo. This one actually wasn't the worst, but it had a very high, like, white cast. Even though I feel like this bottle lasted me a pretty long time, I don't really think I would repurchase this one. Another one I would also not repurchase is the Suave Dry Shampoo. I don't know what really didn't work for me with this one. I just don't think it did enough. I don't think it was as powerful as I would want it to be. I feel like it just didn't do enough for me. Like, I had to use a lot of it for it to do anything to my hair. And so for that reason, I'm most likely not gonna ever repurchase this one. Now, another one I got a sample of that I am not going to repurchase is this Chlorane one. And the reason for this is because this is a first tinted dry shampoo I think I've ever used. So the actual, like, powder that comes out of it, it's tinted. And it does specify that it's for brown to dark brown hair. So if you have darker hair, maybe you'd want to try this one out. This is a dry shampoo with oat milk, and it is for brown to dark hair. So maybe this one would work for you, but for me, I don't think the formula was really bad or anything. It's just the fact that it was tinted, so instead of leaving like a white cast with my lighter hair where I can just kind of shake it in, it gave me like a darker cast. So maybe if you do have darker hair, you would enjoy this one. But you guys, we are done. That is my 2 cents on all the dry shampoos that I have tried in the past few months. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really hope it gave you guys a little bit of insight and, you know, it gave you a couple good recommendations. So for high-end dry shampoos, the ones I would recommend for sure is the Wella dry shampoo. The R&Co was a great, like, scented, good formula dry shampoo. Third one would be the Orbay one. And then if I had to pick two more to go into my favorites category, it'd be the Amika dry shampoo and then also the Living Proof. I feel like the formula on these is really great. I feel like they meet most of my expectations that I do have for a dry shampoo. And these are my top 5 high-end dry shampoos. I definitely don't think I like as many drugstore dry shampoo formulas as I do high-end, but there's nothing wrong with that. I do absolutely love, love, love this Pantene Pro-V one. I also do like my third favorite place would probably be the Tresemme one. But those are my top favorite dry shampoos from the drugstore. But that finally completes the video. This is gonna take me forever to edit, but I am ready to do this for you guys because it has been a long, long time coming. If you enjoyed this review, give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Also, you can follow me on Instagram, superlady246. I do all kinds of beauty, makeup reviews, videos, just, you know, all kinds of different things. But that'd be it for today. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, no matter where you are, no matter what you're doing. I am sending you lots of love from me to you. Stay happy, stay positive, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Lots of love. Bye.